Welcome to a video all about Arctic Psytrance survival fishing in Norway. If you're Arctic Psytrance survival fishing in Norway, there's a few things you'll need. The first thing you'll need is a fishing rod. I got this fishing rod from Trago Mills. It was about £10. It's nothing particularly special. It's probably made of some form of carbon. I'm making a case for it now to take on the plane. I've got a cardboard tube which I'm cutting with a Swiss Army knife to make sure that my fishing rod does not get broken in transit. I'm soon going to be getting into an aeroplane through which you'll need to go through an airport. I've chosen Heathrow and this is Terminal 5. I'm about to put my luggage into the check-in desk, at which point I'll be told that I've got too much baggage in my bag. I'm going to Norway now, which is the next step in this journey. So, thank you very much for watching, and I'll see you soon. When you're Arctic Psytrance survival fishing in Norway, and you're on the plane, it's a very good idea to get yourself a drink. When you go Arctic Psytrance survival fishing, the chances are you'll probably pass through Oslo. Oslo, one of the oldest cities in the world, the gateway to Scandinavia, the capital of Norway, and the most populous place in the northern regions of Europe. So here we are in Oslo. Buildings here are mostly yellow, which is useful if you can't see very well. Now, let me just run you through some basic kit for which you would need if you're going Arctic Psytrance survival fishing. So what we have here, we have some squeezy bags with chili oil, some meditation oil, some deodorant, some toothpaste. We have emergency battery and cable bag. We have a bag of emergency fruit. We have phone charger adapter. Now this is important. This is your fishing tackle. Now I'm going for cod and some mackerel, so I've got myself some feathers. Incidentally, I did go through airport security. They did flash up a concern about the hooks. Now they did go and speak to their manager. You are allowed fishing tackle through airport security, so that's a good precedent to be set. Although having said that, all the hooks did come out when he was looking for it, and I think he might have pricked his finger, but they are legal, so bear that in mind. Over to the secondary bag, we have your mug, pretty standard fare, polycarbonate, pretty lightweight, pretty robust. We have a set of keys to let yourself back in when you get back home. That's pretty important. Several books, ibuprofen. Now this is a good little feature to have. It's a folding gas stove, so you need to get yourself a universal gas bottle. It enables you to cook any fish that you might catch. Tent. That's pretty much of a luxury, really. You don't really need to have a tent if you're Arctic Psytrance survival fishing in Norway. You can pretty much make do with just sleeping in a cave. We have a mess tin and a kettle. Again, bit of a luxury. You know, we're on holiday. Big pile of clothes, different types, t-shirts, pants, socks, a couple of jumpers. You know, don't want to get getting cold or caught out when you're in the Arctic with a Psytrance survival fishing in Norway. water bottle, sun cream. Sun cream, that's pretty important if you're standing by the water. It's good to have a good dose of sun cream on. Head torch, mobile phone, wash bag. So that's really all you need to know about the equipment list for Arctic Psytrance survival fishing in Norway. We're going to take a train later up to the city of Bodø. It's going to be an overnight train. It's going to be some very stunning scenery. So maybe I'll see you on board. When you're Arctic Psytrance survival fishing in Norway, it's extremely important to fill up on water whenever you can. Because even though we're in Scandinavia and water is literally everywhere, they have so much water that they've piped it into people's homes and can come out of a device they call a tap. Now, if you look at this here, this is a very typical Scandinavian tap. So when you have a lever here and you lift it up and then water comes out. Now what you can do is use a water bottle. Now a water bottle is a small container with which you can put water into. It literally contains the water. So this is a red Berghaus bottle. It would cost you around about £8 from a very expensive overpriced outdoor shop. Fortunately, I got this one for free because I purchased a gas stove at the same time. But what you can do is lift up the lever of the tap. And you then have your water. In order to get to the Arctic Circle to do Arctic Psytrance survival fishing, you need to go through Todentheim, and then you can board the train to get to Bodø in order to get to Vaeroy, which is in the Arctic Circle. Because it's very important to be as rested as possible before doing Arctic Psytrance survival fishing, you can opt to take the sleeper train, which you can see an example of a sleeper train here. Even though it's light, because we're approaching the Arctic, it is of course nearly midnight. As you know, that doesn't really make sense. It's nearly midnight, and because we're in the Arctic, it's still light. I did that the wrong way around, but as you can see. Just so you know, I'm not lying about the taps in Scandinavia. Here we are in a train going along in the Arctic Circle, and we've got another tap, and you can use it in much the same way as the previous tap I showed you, except this time it's just moving about slightly because we're on a train. But you can fill up your sink with water and then look out the window.
Yeah.
could one of you please show us where we are on the map?
Here we are now. In Bodø?
Yeah.
Right there.
On the red spot?
Yeah.
Okay.
And we're going to take one of these.
A boat?
A boat.
Yes.
And follow this line. Past the 80 zone?
Yeah.
All the way. Here. To Vaeroy.
Where's the Arctic Circle?
I'm not sure. Oh, it's here. Polar Circle Center.
So we disembarked off the train. The train's over there. You see the train? Anyway, the train is over there somewhere. Don't mind the forfeit. Right. And now we're going to get on a ferry to get to the island of Vaeroy. Is that pronounced correctly?
Vaeroy.
Vaeroy. We're going to Vaeroy. Vaeroy. And this wobbly thing here is the sea. Now, it's in that sea that we're going to find fish. Now, the fish, we're going to combine the fishing rod that I showed you earlier that we put into the cardboard box, and then the fishing tackle I showed you earlier with the fishing tackle with the hooks and things. We're going to put those two things together and we're going to cast them out into that shiny object over there. And then we're going to reel it in and then take whatever we have, and then we're going to work out what to do with it. I don't know what yet. But before we get to Vaeroy, we're going to get on a boat like this, much like this one, but not actually this one. This is bigger than the one we're going on. And I think that's in about an hour.
shining like a national guitar. I am following the river down the highway through the cradle of the Civil War. I'm going to Graceland, Graceland, to Memphis, Tennessee. I'm going to Graceland. Poor boys and pilgrims with families, and we are going to Graceland.
Fishing can be like that. No matter how good you are fishing, things can always go wrong. What preparation to take? Sea can be a cruel mistress.
Thank you.
maybe three fundamental schoolboy errors so far. Firstly, I cast out and I hadn't tied the feathers on properly, so it kind of flew out and I had to go and get it. Secondly, I didn't put the wire, what's this stuff called, the fishing wire, I didn't get that on the correct side of the bar. So it didn't come out, it didn't fly out. Thirdly, got the feathers caught in some seaweed, so we got them stuck. So I don't want to get my feet wet because I don't like getting wet and cold. So we're going to wait for low tide and get the feathers, and then we can carry on doing some mackerel fishing. In the meantime, I've got a beer and there's some music on over there. So this is why it's good doing survival fishing in the Arctic. Okay, so unfortunately you've missed our first attempt, well actually our second attempt at fishing. The first attempt, you probably saw, we made three fundamental errors. We didn't learn from our mistakes, so I've made the mistakes. And so we're now going to go for another attempt. However, I've just lost the fishing float, so we're going to use this bottle here. Improvisation is a very important aspect of fishing, particularly when we've got a fishing weight, it's a bit too heavy, 4 ounce, but of course once this is lost, which inevitably will get lost, I'm going to use a pebble. I could use a pebble anyway, but as soon as I've got the weight, I'm going to do it. So, technique, put it in with your finger, hold it there, open up the trap door, whatever it's called.
Это наш What's wrong, man? Where's the line for your fishing rod?
Well, I lost both my mackerel lines because they kept getting caught in the seaweed and then they get stuck. And so I carried on anyway because it was actually just sitting with the fishing rod that I found out I enjoy. I sat on the rock looking at the sea, it's really nice. And in fact, sat here with my fishing rod, I've just been contemplating. It's actually quite barbaric. Getting fish, like they're a living sentient organism. I don't actually need it, but I've got plenty of food up at the camp. I don't think I've got that killer instinct to actually get a creature from the sea and kill it with my bare hands, effectively for sport. And if I was really hungry, then yeah, maybe I would persist and actually catch a fish, but I just quite like sitting here with a fishing rod. I mean, I can eat seaweed, and I've got lentils and things. And the fish could just carry on their day, and I don't need to bother them, they don't bother me. But on the other hand, I do really like eating fish. Fish is really tasty, so it's a bit of a moral dilemma. I mean, my wife's vegetarian, Katie's vegetarian. She couldn't kill a fish. She would hate the idea of killing it. And the idea of getting a fish, ripping its head off with my bare hands, it makes me a little bit sick.
Again.
There you go.
bloodshed. Although there's been a lot of bloodshed on that dollar bill, if you know what I mean. A lot of blood on the dollar.